so close and yet so far. Oh, I need another chance. I need to know your mercy. Just give me the strength to change within. I know I'm not all that I can be. My weakness seems to get the best of me. But as long as you are here, I know that I will make.
Experience it at LifeGate Power Ministries, the Dominion Arena, number 90, Stadium Road, Rumumasi Road, Port Harcourt.
The best of me.
Father, have your way tonight. And let your word come expressly. And lead us to prayer right. Bless us in Jesus' name. Please be seated. Submit to God. Resist the devil. And you will have victory all the time. Submit to God. Resist the devil. Submit to God, resist the devil. Simple topic. Submit to God, resist the devil. Submit to God, resist the devil. A major secret for breakthrough in life. A major secret for increase, a major secret for victory in life, learning to submit to God and resisting the devil. First thing first, until you submit to God, you cannot resist the devil successfully. The secret of having upper hand over the devil, the secret of defeating the devil in your life, is to first submit to God. James chapter 4, verse 6 and 7. But he giveth more grace. Wherefore he said, God resisteth the proud, but giveth grace unto the humble. Verse 6, verse 7. Submit yourselves, therefore, to God. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you. That's why I tagged my message, submit to God. Resist the devil. Somebody say, submit to God. Resist the devil. Say it again. Submit to God. Resist the devil. So many have been resisting the devil. Devil doesn't answer. Because they have not yet submitted to God. Until you submit to God, devil will not answer you. Because he himself is a rebel. He rebelled against God. So you cannot order him until you have done what he failed to do. Submit to God. Resist the devil. How do we submit to God? Verse 6 says it. But he giveth more grace. Wherefore he said, God resisted the proud, but giveth grace unto the humble. So humility and meekness is the key to submitting to God. Is the secret of submitting to God. Humility, meekness. The meeker you are, the more victorious you are in the kingdom. The more humble you are, the more victorious you will be. The more proud you are, the less victorious you are. Submit to God. Resist the devil. How do you submit to God? Humble yourself. And one of the ways to humble oneself is to cast your cares upon God. First Peter chapter 5, verse 6 and 7. One of the signs of submission, one of the signs of humility is casting your cares upon God. Humble yourselves, 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 6. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due season. Only God can lift up a man. Man cannot lift up himself. Only God can lift you up and sustain you. Anytime man lifts you up, when you annoy him, he can bring his hand down. You just crash. Say, stupid boy. Am I not the one that give you that position? Nonsense. You talk to me that way. But when God lifts you up, he lifts as he has lifted you. When man lifts you up, the day you offend that man, you're in trouble. Are you understanding me? He will call you names. He will mention the time you were born, how you were born, your father, your grandfather, everybody. Last year. He said, now look at it. Put it up again. Verses. Humble yourself therefore under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due season. I want to announce to somebody here, when your due season comes, no man can bring you down. By this prayer and fasting, I declare that your due season has come. I declare that your due season has come. I declare that your due season has come. Your due season of lifting. Your due season of wiping away your tears. Your due season of prosperity. Your due season of God hearing you. Your due season that before you speak, God hears. Your due season before you call, God answers. It's coming on you now. This is your season. This is your time of visitation. By these 3 days fast and prayer, your settlement has come. This is your night of settlement. This is your night of victory. This is your night of due season. This is your night of exaltation. If you believe that, lift your hand and shout hallelujah. Humble yourself in prayer and fasting. Whenever you are fasting, it's a sign of humility. David said, I humble myself in fasting. When they were sick, I humble myself in fasting. Anytime you're fasting, it's a sign of humility. You're abstaining from food. You're seeking the face of God. You're bringing your flesh under. You're starving your flesh of things that make the flesh glory. You're crucifying your flesh before God. And your spirit man is coming alive. Verse 7. Casting all your care upon him, for he cared for you. When someone offends you, you don't take it out at him. You don't take it out at that person. You don't give him truth for truth or third, you know. You don't say, I will retaliate. No. You cast your cares upon God. The Bible says about Jesus Christ that when he was abused, when he was molested, when he was harassed, when he was spat upon, he didn't take the judgment into his hand. But he humbled himself and committed his judgment into the hand of him that is able to judge. Jesus humbled himself. Jesus did not retaliate. Jesus handed over his judgment unto the hand of God. Glory to God. Glory to God. He said, casting all your cares upon him, for he cared for you. Lord, this is beyond me. I don't know how to handle this case. I cast my cares on you. That prayer could come with tears. That prayer will come with burden. It's not a prayer you pray when people are around. Not even your spouse. You lock door against yourself. Oh Lord, this situation is beyond me. I cast my cares on you, for you care for me. And you release your faith, and God at the other end will lift you up from the miry clay and set your feet on the rock and establish your going. Casting your cares upon him, for he careth for you. And look at verse 8. Be sober. Be vigilant. Because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour. Haven't you seen people that take laws into their hand and go to fight? One release, they have opened their eyes in another world. When you take the matter into your hand, you miss God and you attract the devil. Look at verse 9. Look at verse 9. Whom resist steadfast in faith, having knowing that the same afflictions are accomplished in your brethren that are in the Lord. Now go to James chapter 4, verse 6 and 7, where our text came from. Now look at it. Now, James 4, but he giveth more grace, wherefore he said, God resisted the proud, giveth grace unto the humble. Verse 7. Submit yourselves, therefore, to God. Then resist the devil. And what will happen? He will flee from you. What do you do first? Submit to God. Hand over the case to God. In prayer, in fasting. In obedience to the word. Resist him. And he will flee. Now, the picture is this. One translator said, the devil will flee as somebody in terror. Somebody that saw terror and take off with speed. That's what will happen when you fully submit to God. Let's look at Amplified Version. Submit to God. So be subject to God. Resist the devil. Stand firm against him. And he will flee from you. Stand firm in prayer. Stand firm to resist with the word. And he will flee from your matter. Glory to God. Let's look at NIV, that verse 7. And he will say, submit yourself then to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. NLT. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Glory to God. One of the ways to resist the devil, humble yourself. Allow God handle that issue for you. Allow God lead you. Allow God decide for you. How to humble yourself before God? How to submit to God? Trust him with all your heart and lean not unto your own understanding. Trust him with all your heart and lean not unto your own understanding. Trust him with all your heart and lean not unto your own understanding. Trust him with all your heart and lean not unto your own understanding. Psalm 37 verse 4 and 5. Trust the Lord with all your heart and lean not unto your own understanding. Glory to God. Delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desires of thy heart. Verse 5. Commit thy way unto God. Trust also in him. And he shall bring it to pass. 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 Glory to God. Rise to your feet, please. Glory to God. Proverbs chapter 5 and verse. No, Proverbs chapter 3 and verse 5. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart. That's how to submit to God. And lean not unto thy own understanding. Verse 6. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. Don't say this one. I'm a very intelligent person. I can handle it. I don't need to bother God with this. Mm-mm. In all your ways, acknowledge him. Verse 6. In all thy ways, acknowledge him, and he will direct thy paths. He will direct thy path. He will direct thy path. He will show you the way to the top. Glory to God. In all thy ways, acknowledge him. Let's look at NLT in that verse 6. Seek his will in all you do, and he will show you which path to take. Seek his will in all you do, and he'll tell you which path to pray. I was reading a book this morning, just a few minutes ago, and then the writer was saying, there was this conference that was held in Tulsa, Oklahoma, by a very successful pastor. It was conference for pastors, ministers, and this man has a very large church. So people came all over from America. And then they asked the man, what is the secret of your huge success in ministry? What's the secret? And the man was talking and saying, all the seminar was one topic in different ways. I pray, I obey. I pray, I obey. So one minister got angry and talked to the young minister that was writing. He said, you mean I pay this money from this distance to just hear this man very successful tell me that his secret is that he pray and obey? That's all? That's all? But that was the truth. God's ways is not hard. Just simple. Hear him, obey him. He moves you up. Hear him, obey him. He takes you up again. Hear him, you obey him. He takes you up again. So the man was just summarizing the secret of his ministry. And they couldn't believe him. Come on, say, pray, obey. Pray, obey. By that you submit yourself to God. And then when you say, Satan, out! He will run. Lift your hands. Lord, give me grace to submit to God. Give me grace to submit to you in all my ways. Empower me, engrace me to trust you. Engrace me to trust you. Empower me to obey, to pray, hear you, obey you. God said, do this, you do it. God said, don't retaliate, you don't retaliate. God said, forgive that person, you forgive. God said, pray today, you pray. God said, fast today, you fast. God said, go to church, you fast. God said, obey your pastor, you obey him. God said, obey your prophet, you obey him. God said, obey your parents, you obey him. Now God said, now, don't associate with that young person. That person, is a bad company. For evil company, corrupt good manners. You obey him. God said, do this business. You do it. God said, stop what you are doing, that one. Do this one, and then I'll take you up. Resist the devil after submitting to him, and he will flee from you. Oh Lord, in any way I've not submitted to you, forgive me. Cleanse me from all unrighteousness by the blood of Jesus. Go ahead and pray. Lakoshaka, brala teklosia, ekabala bala bala ba, lekala talo tabala lakalo, ebralia talano kosia, ekala tabu, ebralia, kabala tako wando bala ta. Lord Shaka, forgive me, Lord, and cleanse me from all unrighteousness. Forgive me in any way I've not submitted to you, Lord. Forgive me, Lord. Forgive me, Lord. Lero Shakaba, pray. Lord, forgive me. In any way I've not submitted to you. In any way I've walked in disobedience, forgive my disobedience. And grant me grace to obey you from today. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, says the Lord of hosts. Now, all the wealth and prosperity in this world are held by these five regions. The heavens, the earth, the sea, the dry land, the nations. And we're going to use the blood of Jesus and say, Lord, we agree with you. We shake the heavens. We shake the earth. We shake the dry land. We shake the nations. We shake the seas. And we command wealth and prosperity ordained for this church, Life Gate Power Ministries. Wealth and prosperity ordained for members of this commission and friends of this commission. And those who are here, we command you, be pulled to our dimension. Do you know how to pray that prayer now? You pray, use the blood of Jesus to shake the heavens and the earth and the land, the dry land, the seas, and command all the world, hell, by this dimension, be released and be moved into this commission and members of this commission and yourself and your family. Come on now, pray. Bring up Haggai chapter 2, verse 6. By the blood of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, we command by the blood, heavens be shaken, earth be shaken, sea be shaken, dry land be shaken, nations be shaken, and all the deserved foundation come. All the wealth and prosperity meant for this commission, Life Gate Power Ministries, wealth and prosperity, Lekosa, inheritances, held by heavens, by earth, by seas, by dry land, by the nations, oh Shaka, we pull it to our dimension. We pull it to our dimension. We pull it to our dimension. We command you, come. We command you, come into Life Gate Power Ministries. Come to the lives of life getters. Come to my hand. Come to my dimension. Come now. Come now. The blood. The blood. The blood. The blood. The blood. Kata katakowa. Bralia. 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 Bralaka. Bralaka. Ekata. Bralia. Brala. 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 We shake you, heavens, by the blood of Jesus. We shake you, earth, by the blood of Jesus. We shake you, seas, by the blood of Jesus. We shake you, dry land, by the blood of Jesus. We shake you, nations, by the blood of Jesus. All the wealth and prosperity, all the inheritance, all the possession meant for this church, Life Gate Power Ministries, meant for members of this church, myself and family, I pull you to my dimension. I pull you in. I pull you in. Come forth. Come forth. Come forth. Come forth. In the name of Jesus Christ. You know why some occultic men have money? Ill-gotten money from Satan? They get it from the Spirit. You can't be dangerously rich and maintain it until you grab the money from the Spirit realm. Money and wealth is received from the Spirit realm before you can see the manifestation. And we have dislodged and destroyed all the powers in the hand of occulting men and women in this town and wherever you do business. We have taken the power from them tonight. And you begin to shine. You begin to see money. This church begin to see money. They will be using bullion card to come and carry money after service from here. That is the same thing for your company. Get ready, well. That's God. He said, now we should pray about financial harvest. Now, one more prayer, and then we close. Psalm 118, verse 25. Psalm 118, verse 25. Save now, I beseech thee. O Lord, O Lord, I beseech thee, send now prosperity. So it's in the Bible to command prosperity. Save now, I beseech you, O Lord. You are going to say, Father, in the name of Jesus, and by the blood of Jesus, save now, I beseech thee, O Lord. O Lord, I beseech thee, send now prosperity. Pray in the name of Jesus. Father, bring that scripture up. Father, in the name of Jesus, save now by the blood of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, and by the blood of Jesus, save now. I beseech thee, O Lord, I beseech thee, send now prosperity. 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 Send now prosperity into this commission, Life Gate Power Ministries, into my life, into our lives. Yes, 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 yes. Send now prosperity. Send now prosperity. Send now prosperity. Save now. I beseech thee. O Lord, send now prosperity. Send now prosperity. Send now prosperity. In the name of Jesus.